So when was someone going to tell me that Photoshop now has a built-in AI? I woke up this morning and just started casually editing some photos in Photoshop, as I like to do, and I noticed that Photoshop now has a feature under filters that's called neural filters. I guess they were too scared to call it artificial intelligence filters, but it seems like that's essentially what it is. Now, I haven't tested this as far as just going in and downloading the packages, because apparently what it does is it takes your photo, uploads it to the cloud to do all the processing. I guess it's too intensive for Photoshop on your computer to handle it. So let's test this and see what happens. I've opened this photo and right off the bat, I noticed that we've got skin smoothing. So if I flick this guy on, so it's kind of done like a Snapchat or TikTok filter type thing where it just smooths your appearance. I don't think I look that bad, but when I turn the filter on and take it off, like I do have fairly deep set eyes. People are always commenting, "You look so tired, you need to go take a nap." That's literally just the way I look. Okay, so beta filter. So this is what kind of piqued my interest. So you can change your emotions, facial hair, age or pose details, makeup transfer. Okay. All right, here we go. Oh my gosh. Okay, so it's like, it doesn't make my face white. What I really want to jump back to is this smart portrait feature. So I'm already pretty smiley in this photo, so I don't know if happiness. Oh my gosh, that is so creepy. It's giving me teeth. It scrunches my face in. What if I do the opposite? So I'm sad. This is not too bad. This is believable, like, yeah, let's try surprise. Oh, it seems like it just made me sad. I guess because I'm already surprised in this image. If I do negative surprise, it seems to be doing a better job. Like, that's not the shape of my face, but if you were trying to make a composition and sell the fact that someone was surprised, like for an ad or something, anger. So let's take me from happy to angry. I don't know, I don't think this one's not so believable. If I'm angry, it's like I get these things on my forehead, these lines. Oh, what's going on with... Let's go. Facial age. So if I just took myself, is it gonna add like facial hair? Is it gonna give me wrinkles? Yeah, okay, so it gave me wrinkles. It kind of made me look a little bit chubbier. What if I go down and I want to make myself younger? It gave me more hair. So what if I combine that with skin smoothing? That is like a weird version of my younger self, but like not at all. The facial age, it kind of cleans up some of my facial hair down here and then adds like more up there. Did it make my ears smaller? I don't like it. What about my gaze? It's like shifting my eyes. So younger and less hair. Okay, so I can kind of give myself a haircut. What if I want way more hair? Oh, look, it gave me a mullet or something. And tried, I don't know what's going on with my lips. Okay, let's try this one, which is a little bit more of a neutral expression. Let's start with that. Yeah, it's like weird. It just makes me look glowy. Let's go full happiness, because I'm pretty serious in this photo, and I want to see what teeth it's going to give me. Lovely chapped lips right here. Oh, that is weird. Did it pull from a stock library of teeth randomly? Like, it didn't even give me nice looking teeth. What if I like up my surprise level? Like, oh my gosh, I'm so surprised. Thank you, Photoshop, for thinking so highly of me. What? It opened the teeth, but like really weirdly. This is a different person. I wanna see if it will give me like a manly beard. Give me like a really manly beard. It didn't do what I was hoping it would do. Happiness, zero. No, I look like a wildling from Game of Thrones or something. Like, no, thank you. So here's a photo of myself that my friend Josh took. I actually like it. The only problem is that it's taken in direct sun, so I'm kind of squinting and I've got like this forehead thing. So I'm curious if the artificial intelligence could get rid of it, because I think, you know, if you just, then I look pretty happy. Just, okay, a little bit angry, not so bad. I wonder if I tell it to take away some anger here, it'll actually solve that. It kind of just made me look a little bit more flat. It brought my lips in. It kind of just makes me look a little bit like, But you know, it could look a little bit more majestic and believable if I added more hair. Oh my gosh, I got rid of my sunglasses. My hair just looks perfectly combed. I have like Andrew Garfield hair or something. It's like a weird afro. Can I change my eye direction? Gaze, can I look more to the left? It changed my eyelashes. It did kind of work. Like it doesn't look like me anymore. Can I change my head? Can I make my head? Oh, that's crazy. I think subtle adjustments are where it's at. Now, the one thing I do like about this that is maybe useful, if you're someone who does frequency separation to retouch faces, I could totally see this AI face smoothing feature be a thing where instead of doing frequency separation, you have a layer where you have the smooth version of the face, and because it's on a separate layer, you can turn it on and off and then brush it in. I wanna try this more neutral expression of myself. I just took this photo. And I want to see if it can actually make myself look believably happier. Let's bump the happiness up here. Oh my gosh. Again, it's just like somehow assumed my teeth structure for my face. It hasn't made me look happy at all. What? Photoshop. Surprise. It made my face longer. This is bad. This is bad. Can I aim my eyes up? I think it's just left and right. Yeah, so right is right and left is left? Oh, it does some really weird things to my eyelashes. What? I could see it. I could see it. Hair thickness. Please give me a beard. Please give me a beard to cover what's... Oh, it's not aesthetically pleasing at all. Ah. Okay, so if I cover the lower portion of my mouth, the upper portion is believably angry, but the lower portion, I don't know what's going on. Let's toggle the happiness off here. Oh, I'm surprised angry. Ooh. My eyeballs got bigger too. Oh, what the heck? My hair? I look like a dog. I'm sorry if you look like this. I just don't know what's going on. Let's make me younger again. Maybe that will help. No, it didn't help. Older? It made my chin fatter. Oh. What if I lower my facial age and make myself younger? Happiness, 0. Surprise, 0. Anger, 100. Before, after. Let's put the gaze back to where it's supposed to be. No anger, no surprise, no happiness. I mean, I got happier. With no happiness, I got happier. The starting photo is very neutral. The ending photo, I went from like, to that. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. It's a little bit silly at this point. It closed my eyes. Let's put the hair back. I get it. I'm taking it to the extreme, so it kind of doesn't work. It's kind of cool, but also kind of terrible at the same time. One more. Should we do it? This is the sad child didn't want to be in the family portrait face, and we have to fix it now. Happiness. We gotta go full happiness. Yeah, I mean... Can I get rid of anger? If I remove anger... It just closed my eyes. Like, I guess it's assuming you smile and you get more squinty. The teeth. I promise I have tried my hardest to make this work. It's probably because I chose photos that are a little bit tough. Comment your favorite pose in the bottom. I mean, I really don't know. I can see why a lot of these filters are in beta. People are gonna wanna use them to like enhance their appearance or the way they look. And other than maybe the skin smoothing, like not one of these features made me look better in any way. I definitely didn't look happier. When I tried to remove anger and sadness, it just did the opposite. Like, the skin smoothing worked pretty well. Happy Trinket was not too bad with the makeup. Innocent schoolboy with an afro. There was Wildling from Game of Thrones with the horrible teeth. That's gonna give me nightmares for sure. Maybe Muskrat Man and old creepy guy looking to the left. I don't know. I don't think if you push the filters too far, it just becomes unbelievable. But a little bit here and there, not too bad. I'm a bit terrified. I will say that. Anyways, if you like this video, make sure you check out some of my other Lightroom tutorials. And until then, I'll see you next time. I'm still having nightmares about Wildling Man and Muskrat. Oh.